What's good, YouTube? This is your boy RJ Watts, back with another video for you guys. Now, this video is pertaining to my defense. A lot of people was like, yo, when are you going to release your defense? Because I run a particular defense that is casually normal, but at the same time, it's not necessarily that normal. A lot of people don't run this defense. If you guys know, there are about, five to six different defensive settings, from man to zone to trap and to four-court press. Now I really run this, so this is like my go-to defense, and the reason why it is because it's my main outlet defense to fill out my opponent. And what I mean by saying fill out my opponent is I like to see what is their IQ, their basketball knowledge. Do they have the knowledge to pertain to be at that level of playing against my zone defense? And that zone that I'm talking about is a 3-2 zone. Jax, what the hell are you doing making all that damn noise in my video? Like I was saying, now in regards to just being able to play this defense, understanding what you have to do, what you can do against my defense, it's really intriguing, because at the end of the day, you have some that don't know what to do, and that's the reason why I run my 3-2 zone. Go ahead and go into some gameplay. I'm just gonna go up against, do like a little domination game or so, just to show you my defensive settings, what I do, why I do it, how I do it, and you know what I'm saying, all that good stuff. So you guys can get a level of what to see. Now really, online is very different, because you have a lot of people that you play online that is a user. They control their team. So meaning that they have to adjust to my defense. And if they don't adjust, they will fold. The AIs on here, they tend to adjust. They see certain things that they can do, and they see certain things that they can't do. But sometimes I trick the AI, because at the end of the day, they look at it as a straight strategic 3-2 zone, but the rotations need to be quick. As far as in this defense, and the reason why I run my defense, and is in itself. So going here, when we went to the game, we always call my defensive settings, right? I go into my defensive settings, as we always would do online. Go to, and now these are my defensive settings for you guys that want to know. Normally I do tight, on ball pressure, tight, off ball pressure, switching on ball and off ball, stay attached. Now the reason why I stay attached, because when you read it, it says hedge the defender will stay attached to the screener. When on your own on ball pick and roll coverage will change to go under. Now pretty much, if you ever pay attention, what is to stay attached, and you see how the spacing between, say for instance, the screener, the man that's sticking the screener, you see how he can like stay attached to the screener tight, or he can stay off. I mean, sometimes it's best to do it yes. I do yes a lot. Sometimes I do no as well. So I stick with yes, starting out just to see what my opponents would do. I switch off ball on the screens. I leave pre-rotation off because I do my own manual pre-rotation. Everything is switch all, no help defense. Really depends on who you playing. You know what I'm saying? This is my defensive settings out the gate, because I don't know how the person is going to play until I realize how they play. Then I change it over if I have to. Now going into the actual game itself, I'm gonna show you what I do in regards to when they get the ball, I'm gonna let them get the ball first, actually. So they're gonna get the ball. I'm gonna go straight to the 3-2 zone. Now, you have your different four options here, and the four options you have is switch everything, four corners, tight, stay home, straight up, shrink the floor, no threes, and neutral. Now, what I like to do out the gates is I like to go for the four corners. You know what I'm saying? And the reason why I go for four corners is because 9 times out of 10, the user's mindset is to throw it to the corner. Especially when running my zone, because pretty much when you run a certain zone, you want to cut off the biggest points of what can break your zone the most. And a 3-2, what can break your zone the most is the corners. So the first mindset of an opponent, if they don't know how to beat a 3-2 zone, their first mind is, I'm just going to throw it to the corner. But little do they know, I'm always at the corners. Because what happens is that 3-2 zone spaces out. You know what I'm saying? It spaces out when you run four corners tight, and it keeps the corners tight, so that way they can't get that corner pass off every single time. Another one that I would do Another one that I would do is shrink the floor. Now, shrink the floor, mainly, it'll tighten up the spacing between the 3-2 zone. I mean, you'll get, so pretty much the corners will be super open damn near. You see how that's super open like that? That's what pretty much shrink the floor is, because it'll tighten up the 3-2 zone itself. So that way, say if you got people that like the rim run, you know what I'm saying? That means the help defense will always be there from both the wing players. You'll have a lot of the help defense. You'll be able to step up and contest, all that good stuff. Now, every time on defense, normally, say if a fast break is coming, right? They get the ball, they're going to the floor ASAP. Off a rebound, off your miss. You always want to make sure you highlight and go back to 3-2 zone ASAP. You want to go back to 3-2 zone ASAP. So watch this. I'm gonna click on it again, because what happens is they'll go back into step up. If you don't do that, bro, the AIs will start acting goofy and don't step up on defense. They'll act like they don't know what they're doing. So you have to put them back in the defensive setting to play the part, to be ready for everything. I know I have a lot of things I can talk about the 3-2 zone. I just want to talk to you guys a little bit more about it, because I know a lot of you guys are like, man, how do you do that? How do you do this? How do you do that? When I definitely play some more, when I do grinded accounts and stuff like that, I'll definitely record it, get another video out to show you how much, as far as in how I do everything that I, what I do. What else I do is I go to rebound. I like to crash the glass, and I like to aggression play physical. I like to be physical on the floor, because I like for them to be ready to be reactive. I like them to be active on the floor, watch those passing lanes, being able to be ready to get in those passing lanes. Another one I like to do, I'm going to show you one more that I like to do as far as within my 3-2 zone itself. What do you guys also want to see as far as in my video? Because I know like this is my first defense video, me dropping for you guys. I know you guys have been waiting for it. I like to also do protect the perimeter. The main focus of my team is shooting threes. So when I got my four out corners tight and protect the perimeter, that means we're going out to contest that perimeter three ball shot. You know what I'm saying? Being ready at all times to be ready, be proactive, and guard the three. A lot of people run wall up. So if you run wall up, transition focus, wall up is stopping the people from rim running. You know what I'm saying? Like, people trying to force a rim run, turn on wall up. That'll cut all that nonsense out, especially with somebody with Hall of Fame clamps. Definitely recommend doing that. Now, another thing, when running my zone itself, I will also show you ways on how to break a zone, how to break certain zones, also how to run certain freelances that I run. I know you guys are like, yo, how do you do your pull-up shots and stuff like that? These are a lot of questions that I can answer, and I can definitely get videos out for you guys. You guys just let me know what you guys want to see next in the next video. I definitely do appreciate you guys coming through, showing your boy some love on the video content I'm dropping. This is for you. So remember, running a 3-2 zone, if you want to play this, right, you worry about baiting. So if the low key, which what I normally do is I'll stay wide right here, come back up, go back down to the corner, because at the end of the day, say for instance, a user, say if I'm playing against a user, they'll drive to the lane, their first mindset is to think that left corner is open, but I switched over so fast to my small forward that I backdropped to that corner. It comes with a lot of rotation switches, it comes with switching, it comes with knowing who you're switching to, it comes with movement, it comes with speed, it comes with pressing the square button to react to the steal, to grab the steal, and going in the tempo. Now I play on my camera angle is 2K low, 6 zoom, 2 is the height, and this really does help my 3-2 zone become super effective, because I get those angles that not a lot of angles can get. I know brought 2K with the 2K over the head, you can see that, but it looks like I'm playing Madden, and I don't like having a Madden camera playing 2K. I like to be level-headed on the floor when playing 2K. But this is your boy RJ Watts TV coming to you with another video of my 3-2 zone, how I run it, when I run it, why I run it. If you guys want more information and detailed videos in regards to how to break it, how to run another defense, how to run a certain offensive set, please comment in the section below. Subscribe if you're new to the Lace Up Crew. You know the vibes. Throw it up the thumbs up button, man. Hey, subscribe. Let's try to get to 2K. Let's try to get to 5K pretty soon. Let's push for greatness. I really appreciate all y'all's support. It's your boy. You dig?